I thank you very much, the Chief Justice of the Federation, for taking the initiative and bringing all those under you to come and welcome me back home after a long stay in the United Kingdom under the treatment of their specialists. I congratulate you most sincerely for your appointment as the Chief Justice of Nigeria and the other heads of courts here present, and justices and judges of the various jurisdictions here present on the new legal year 2017-2018. In my Independence Day broadcast on the first of this month, I pray the judiciary for the present initiative in setting up special courts to speedily try corruption cases and for appointment of Justice Salami to head the Corruption Trial Monitoring Committee. Heads of courts should designate in their various jurisdictions one or more courts as special courts to speedily try corruption and financial crime cases, and for Supreme Court and Court of Appeal to fix special dates each week for hearing and determining appeals from special courts. This is my loud thinking. You know how to do it better than myself. We need a new approach to prison congestion. It is a national scandal that many prisons are overcrowded by up to 90%. Urgent new measures should be put in place to speedily decongest prisons, not only in the interest of justice, but to save costs of prison maintenance and welfare of prisoners. My Attorney General is advocating establishment of courts inside the prisons to speed up cases, to speed up decongestion. The logistical problems of transporting prisoners from prison to courts means average waiting period for every suspected detainee is 5 years. This is really bad. Review of judicial officials' conditions of service, we'll take to that. We are not unmindful of the daunting challenges faced by the judiciary in the areas of infrastructure and funding. This informed our decision to increase the judiciary's budget in the 2017 fiscal year, which we are committed to sustain. So really, we have just started working, and we hope God in his infinite mercy will give Nigeria the patience to tolerate us. Thank you very much indeed.